mail it in Friday.
You're walking there like you dropped something in your drawers.
No chance. That's how I walk, with a strut, confidence, knowing that I'm going to be hosting a terrific television program and that you, the viewer, are going to enjoy it for the entire hour. It's SportsCenter with Jay and Dan. I'm Jay, that's Dan. Yesterday, we mentioned the two surprise teams to us in the National Hockey League to the quarter point of the season, the Devils and Canucks.
Guess who we're meeting Friday?
I guess Gary Bettman was watching.
That's right.
He scheduled it.
He arranged it specifically because of our conversation. It's the Canucks and Devils. Hockey Fights Cancer Night at the Prudential Center. Brian Boyle, his wife Lauren, and two children, Declan and Isabella, taking part in the ceremonial face-off. Boyle diagnosed with a rare form of leukemia in September before returning to the lineup November 1st. The entire Devils team wore Boyle Strong 11 patches on their lavender-colored jerseys during warm-up. And Boyle, wow, he made it a night to remember. To Hockey Fights Cancer Night, Brian Boyle scores his second goal since returning from his cancer diagnosis. Boyle on the fans chanting his name.
How about that? I'd like to tell you I was dialed in on the game, but I heard it loud and clear. And you know, thank you. Thank you, everybody. It's remarkable, the support that I've got.
And first star of the game, Boyle. Canucks three-game win streak. Over.
He played his 12th game as a Devil.
Leafs and Hurricanes, after struggling in October, Freddie Anderson leading all goalies in November with a .945 save percentage. And he was busy early on. Jumping on the rebound, Anderson, he'll shut the door. One of five saves on that penalty kill. Mike Babcock put Josh Levo in the lineup for the first time in almost 2 weeks.
Give us these guys an opportunity. They've been practicing hard. We'll get them out here and see what they can do. Every time you get an opportunity, you got to do something with it. And that's no different here tonight.
So what would Levo do with this opportunity? Midway through the second, 1-0 Leafs. Andreas Borgman flips it for Levo, and yes, he scores just as we drew it up. The Van Riemsdyk family was in attendance. Everybody has glasses. James facing off against brother Trevor. Late second, 3-1. Van Riemsdyk fires it past his brother Trevor off the post. Anderson finishing with a season-high 43 saves as Toronto hangs on for a 5-4 victory.
Oilers and Sabres from Buffalo. Connor McDavid and Jack Eichel, the 2015 first and second overall picks, going toe-to-toe for the third time. Eichel yet to score when facing McDavid. There it is, high and wide. Just two goals so far this month. Second period, Eichel, another great opportunity. Again, he fires it wide. Yes, stupid stick. Under two to play in the period. McDavid can't get a stick on the point shot. McDavid held pointless in this game. Third period. Eichel, seventh of the season, the game winner. We remind you, bath salts are dangerous. Boyle have lost 4 of 5. Buffalo snaps a 7-game skid.
Disastrous loss for Edmonton. Meanwhile, Winnipeg looking great. Looking for their 6th win in their last 7. They were in Anaheim. Comes loose to friend of SportsCenter with Jay and Dan, Mark Scheifele. But hang on. Anaheim challenges that Scheifele tally because it does look like Blake Wheeler is offside. Randy Carlyle, the former Jet great, challenged. Calls overturned. We're still scoreless, but 28 seconds later on TSN. Ehlers with his 9th, 1-0, still in the frame. Winnipeg keeping it coming. Tyler Myler's 2. Ehlers, short side, 6th career multi-goal game. Later, a scrum ensues. Corey Perry and Ben Sherratt exchange a few shots, and it's Sherratt with the butt end to Perry's mouth. And that begins a massive brawl.
Oh,
Harry Leakin, not doing well, not happy. Jets had an empty netter. Jets win again.
Did we mention every Canadian team was in action except the Habs, Flames, and Stars? Johnny Gaudreau. Far side on Ben Bishop. Evening, Bishop! Gaudreau saw his 10-game point streak snapped on Wednesday in Columbus. Starts a new one, gives Calgary the lead. Gaudreau leading a rush. Watch the no-look backhand dish to a streaking Sean Monahan. Buries his second of the night, puts Calgary back in front. But fourth Calgary mistake directly leading to a goal. Dallas takes the lead. The Flames pull Smith for the extra attacker. Doesn't matter. Sagan gets the hat trick. Calgary blows three separate leads as they lose 6-4.
And Dan mentioned it. Six of the seven Canadian teams in action. Here's the Sens in Columbus. Ottawa's lost four straight. Facing Sergei Bobrovsky, two shutouts, four goals against, and a 974 save percentage over a five-game win streak. He beats Bobrovsky! Being right is not a bulletproof vest, Bobrovsky! Ottawa's up 1-0. Second frame after the Jackets took the lead. Short side of Bobrovsky.
Scores!
Bobrovsky, two goals allowed on just eight shots. Case is closed, Bobrovsky finished. Over, go to lunch. Game tied at two now. Ryan DeZingle, which is also a fun name to say. Unable to get it over a sprawling Bobrovsky. However, here's the Bobrovsky throws his stick, causing DeZingle to lose control. Could have been a penalty shot. The Sens certainly thought it should have been a penalty shot. The game stays tied. The Sens have now dropped five straight, 5-2 the final in this.
Did you know that through 17 games last season, your Toronto Raptors were 11-6? Did you also know that after 17 games this season, your Toronto Raptors are? You got it. 11-6. And this point last season is when the Raptors really hit the gas. See if it was a repeat performance. They're taking on the Pacers. Toronto led by 10 at the half. They allowed a 28-0 run in New York on Wednesday, third quarter. Bojan Bogdanovic on the curl gets the hoop in the arm. In just 5 minutes, the Raptors lead. It's gone. Raptors were outscored 31-20 in the third. Battle between DeMar DeRozan and Stevenson in the fourth. Stevenson, three of his 18 off the bench. Pacers up 11 2 minutes ago. DeRozan drives inside, reverse layup, the lead, it's down to three. DeRozan shoved out of the way by Stevenson. No foul call. Could have been free throws to bring the Raptors even closer. Stevenson loses it. Levels DeRozan the other way again. No call. Dwayne Casey? Guys? Hello? DeRozan not happy. Gets into Stevenson's face. DeRozan, a chance to tie. The layup is no good. They got hit on the arm there.
And Turner is fouled.
DeRozan finished with 13 points as the Raptors do not step on the gas as they lose instead. 107-104.
Back to hockey. It was this year's top team of the Western Conference against last year's Western Conference champs. I guess you could say it's a Western-style showdown. And at the end of Friday's game between the Blues and Predators, someone would be dead.
What?
Rene, picking up his 45th career shutout, passes Mika Kiprusoff for most by a Finnish-born goaltender.
Sharks and Golden Knights, what do you get when you play hockey in Vegas? These creepy guys.
Nothing like a little Blue Man Group performance.
Yeah, nothing like a little Blue Man Group. Off the draw to start the second. Knights power play. Could you zoom it? Change the camera. Zoom in. What is... Change the camera. Of course, the game winner. Golden Knights pull out a win. They remain first in the Pacific. Before the show, we were talking with one of our producers about the Grey Cup, and he admitted he had not yet been to one. That's when Jay and I looked at him with envy, knowing that this young man will one day experience for that first time the pure joy and unabashed show that is your first Grey Cup. He's not going this weekend. Start your chili prep now.
Yeah.
And again, the key to a good chili, you want a 70-30 meat to bean ratio. Too many beans, it's garbage.
Cut down on the beans.
Yeah, no one wants to eat a boatload of beans.
Well, sometimes you want to eat a boatload of beans.
No.
Next week, our walkover clock will be sponsored by Boatload of Beans. New restaurant that Dan will be starting in his hometown. The CFL is considering moving the Grey Cup to October. Friday, Commissioner Randy Ambrosi explained why.
Imagine playing our Grey Cup. Let's just pick, you know, let's just say third week of October when it's beautiful everywhere and you don't have to wear 900 layers of clothing. And you don't have to go get your, you know, your winter boots out. And you imagine how much bigger the festival would be when people are wearing, you know, long sleeve shirts and a sweatshirt and not a parka and a toque. I think through that lens, it could be so cool for the Canadian Football League to do it.
I like that guy a lot.
Yeah.
He's a cool cat.
But here's the thing. So I do like the idea. Secondly, isn't the joy and the mystique of the CFL seeing the old Grey Cup footage of them playing in the snow and everyone frigid?
Yes. And also, I would also point out, third week of October, it's not necessarily beautiful everywhere. No. Not necessarily. Having said that, as Larry David would say, I actually always liked this idea, moving the season back a bit. Partially because I'd love to see what it'd be like to play the Grey Cup a few weeks earlier.
Even, yeah, just maybe 2 weeks.
Just 2 weeks. I'm thinking you split the difference, because it's funny, because Chris Cuthbert, voice of the Grey Cup, sent this tweet out earlier tonight. Big Randy Ambrosi fan as well, but altering the schedule by month would be a huge mistake. Training camp preseason would be lost to Stanley Cup playoff focus, playoffs and cup by World Series and NHL loss. I actually disagree with Chris just on that fact. I think the CFL has a dedicated audience that would follow it regardless if the cup playoffs are going on or regardless if the World Series is going on. But, you know, I'm with you. 2 weeks. Move it back 2 weeks. I think that would make everybody
happy. I agree with everything Chris Cuthbert has said and will say. Tuffy the Horse continued an annual Stampeders Grey Cup tradition. Visited a hotel lobby in Ottawa on Friday. Let's see how his check-in went. Okay. He walks in. He says, okay, and where's the reception desk? I'll just go over here. I booked on hotels.com. No, you don't have my reservations.
Well, then I'll come behind the desk and book my own room. Noon carrots are available in this lobby. What a coincidence.
Apparently, Dan, that is the horse from the hit series Murdoch Mysteries. Of course, that horse plays Murdoch and solves mysteries.
Horse mystery? This is a job for me.
Are you suffering from Grey Cup fever?
Yeah.
We can help.
Did you know that 2 out of every 9 CFL football teams play in the Grey Cup every year? Did you know that over 90% of fans will be affected by some type of Grey Cup fever? Aggressive rowdiness, Grey Cup overstimulation, or ARGOS, is a condition that irritates all Calgary Stampeder fans. If you or someone you love has come down with a case of Grey Cup fever, Stamfedrin is here to help. Stamfedrin is the only medication proven to ease ARGO fans' expectations. Call today if you suffer from dry mouth, face painting, enlarged balls, cheering for a rouge, naming your firstborn child Ricky Ray, whether it's a boy or a girl, refusing to drink out of anything other than the Grey Cup, and diarrhea. If you experience any of these symptoms, rush to the end zone immediately. Ask your doctor if your team is healthy enough this late into the season. Ask for Stamfedrin today.
Good idea. Guess what? Carey Price is going to start Saturday when the Habs host the Sabres. Whoa. Missed the last 10 games with a lower body injury. Montreal's lost its last 5. Currently sits 6 points out of a playoff spot, more than a quarter of the way through the season. Price, though, there's plenty of time to make up ground, and I believe he de-aged about 5 years from having not played. Playing here.
Good mustache on Andrew Shaw.
Very good. Mobro.
Still to come. What is going on with former NBA MVP Derrick Rose? We'll tell you after this on SportsCenter with Jay and Dan. ESPN's Adrian Wojnarowski is reporting that Derrick Rose is away from the Cleveland Cavaliers, contemplating his future in basketball. A sprained ankle will keep Rose out a couple more weeks, and according to Woj, the devastating and persistent injuries that have derailed the former number one overall pick's career since he became the youngest player ever to win MVP honors in 2010-2011 have become a difficult burden for the 29-year-old Rose to bear. Yes, he's still just 29 years old, so no Rose for LeBron and the Cavs as they hosted the Charlotte Hornets. LeBron playing over 37 minutes a game this year. Head coach Tyronn Lue says, I played with Jordan. When he was 39, he played 37 minutes a night. One of the greats, sometimes you gotta play. The Cavs are rolling now.
It's the Jannies, collection of bad and good plays named after Craig Janney.
Love that. Duke, Texas, Kerwin Roach the second. What a dunk. Duke, it's Texas, it's college hoops.
Western Kentucky against Florida International. This is a punt attempt by Jake Collins. It's not.
Someone described this
it was
as
a
the
fake
worst
punt.
Football play of all time.
I think I would have to agree. Devontae Price with a 38-yard fumble return. Yeah, he bailed out on that one. Then he's like, this is not going well. I'll just give up on this play. Nope, I'll continue on. Someone take the football, please.
Gonna end up with a college education. Nobody
looks good in this. Michael Hasty thrown hard out of bounds. Do they still have Hasty Marts? They're a chain of convenience
stores.
Yeah,
are there still Hasty Marts, producer Tim?
Well, those are still around. Hasty Market.
Is it Hasty? Oh yeah, it's Hasty Market. That's right.
Then they still have around.
They're still there.
So hats off to Hasty Market. You're still in business.
I always wondered if the alternate name was Relatively Quick Market. Bulls, Warriors, two-time MVP Steph Curry. Wow.
The name Hasty Market intimidates me because I'm like, do I have to like?
Yes. Get in and get out, quick.
It's just frantic. I can't deal with that.
Yes. Get your chips and go.
Look at this cleanup guy at the FIBA World Cup qualifiers. That doesn't seem real, and I don't think the game was going on. This is all fake. There's not a game.
Oh. Isn't that twerking? God. Why did producer Tim put that in the show?
We'll never know.
He is a sick man.
NHL media scrums can get pretty cramped, and for some reporters, the only way to get that soundbite is to lurk in the background. Which brings us to this week's edition of our new favorite segment, NHL Scrum Lurkers. Another edition of NHL Scrum Lurkers.
All right, it's time for the Jay and Dan mailbag. This is a fun segment we love to do where we answer your letters or tweets. This first one is from our good friend. Before we get to that, I like to show this. All right, there's letters in the mailroom here at TSN. All right, Jeremy David writes, Jay Onright, with that upper lip sweater, you almost look like a distant relative of former TSN legend Jim Van Horn. Let's take a look. In our very famous segment, are they related? Dan, are we related?
The rest of the face, no. That mustache, yes.
Practically identical. Hoo-ha, it's the weekend.
Brett asks, do you ever worry that because Twitter's made the character limit 280 characters that someone's going to ask a question so long that producer Tim loses it because the tweet won't fit in a graphic and the segment has gone on too long since it took so long to read the question?
No. And Jerry asks, what's your go-to happy place, Dan?
Anywhere not near producer Tim.
Okay. For me, it's the toilet. And this has been the Jay and Dan mailbag. The Jay and Dan podcast is Canada's most popular and critically acclaimed podcast, according to Podcaster Magazine, a magazine that folded 10 months ago. It's sponsored by Coors Light.
We're going to wrap things up when we come back, and then we're going to peel out of the studio.
Yeah, we are. We're going to leave faster than the guys in the cows are all free.
This January, all eyes are on Canada. Canada as music superstars aim to create a breakthrough song.
I got chills all over my body.
Mentored by legendary music mogul Scott Borchetta, the man behind Taylor Swift.
We're launching your song right now.
For these breakthrough artists, one song can change everything.
Boom! Yes!
The launch, this January on
Bam. I gotta say, this has been a terrific show. And I feel like it's time to focus on our Movember. Oh, we didn't. Producer Tim says we didn't blow anything.
Clean show.
Yeah.
It always seems to happen when we mail it in, we're at our best.
It's funny. Oh, we got to do the Danta Claus segment.
Yeah. Reminder, send in your letters to Danta Claus. Send your sports wish list. So maybe your little 6-year-old Billy or 7-year-old Sally has a wish. Get them to write it down, take a picture, and send it to us at Jay and Dan.
According to our social media guy, Danny Wright, terrific guy, growing a great mustache for Movember. He says there's a lot of great letters already to Danta.
No one's taking pictures of them, though. They're just sending in tweets, so send in that.
All right, so here we go, Movember with myself and Dan.
So this bad boy going to its first Grey Cup.
Yeah, and it's very, well, not first
Grey Cup. The rest of you.
Oh, I see.
But that mustache.
This one, but I got to say, though, it's getting out of there. Like, it's getting out of control on the sides there. This one, it's going to a Ross Petty Christmas show this weekend. Merry Christmas, Dan Stash.
Yeah, walks in. He's like, okay, and where's the reception desk? I'll just go over here. I booked on hotels.com. Yeah.